Hey babies, it is me back in another video, and today I'm going to be doing part two of the girls talk video. Part two, and first thing we're going to be talking about in this partial is journaling. Not only journaling, but talking to yourself, making notes, making notes in your phone, just anything. So journaling, I feel like it's a big thing because you get to write your emotions, how you feel. Like in this journal, actually, for example, I used to write in this journal when I used to be very, very depressed. Like, you guys may seem like, she's young, she don't know what depression is. Like, I'm telling you, they start young, guys, because, man, the things I used to write in a journal about myself, like, it was not cute at all. Like, I don't know, like, I used to really hate myself sometimes, and all I did was journal. All I did was talk to myself. Like, I have my MacBook, and I literally record myself, and I just talk to myself. And then I look back into the videos, and you actually learn from it. You learn from the journaling. So, actually, let's look in this journal, because I feel like I've really been processing well. So let's see the last time I wrote something in this journal, because this is my bad journal. So let's look. The last time I wrote it in this journal was last year, October 12th. Do you guys see the big difference? I feel like that's a big growth. I feel like I haven't had like a big problem ever since during that time, and like during the summer, during the time I was coming back to school, that was during the time I was having the problem the most. But yeah, not only journaling, but talking to yourself really helps. Like, people might think you crazy, like, why is this girl talking to herself? But you're really just having that mindset and really just telling yourself good things, you know. And when I talk to myself in my MacBook, like, yeah, I go back to them. I do this, I do that, you know. It's better for yourself, you know. It's really healthy to have all these emotions with you, even though it's bad, good. You can always go back to them to see, like, how much you process for real, you know. But, yeah, that's one thing, journaling. That's a big thing. Like, buy you guys a journal or start writing in your notes or... Yeah, start doing that, because, man, that is something. Okay, the next thing I would say is read books. Books, journaling is kind of the same thing, but not really. Books, learning about books about, like, just getting any type of book. It could be any type of book. It could be a gospel book. It could be a book about you learning about yourself. It could be a book about this girl that's going through something that you want, that you see her point of view of her story and, like, how she fixed herself and stuff. So, this is the book I'm going to be recommending you guys. This book is called It's All Love, Reflections for Your Heart and Soul by Jenna Ortega. Yes, guys. Jenna Ortega that be on the TV Wednesday, Stuck in the Middle, where else she be at? Well, mostly those that I know her from, but she's in many stuff. But yeah, she made her own book, and she talked about her life. Like, she talked about the goals that she went through to make it up to here. Like, she been through a lot ever since she was a kid, and, like, man, you would see, like, she talks about a lot of stuff in this. I'm gonna actually read the side to show you guys. Okay. I want my readers to know that you are not alone. We are in this together. Jenna Ortega has had to balance her acting career, her private life, and many public expectations from a young age. And she learned that she can only get through it by leading with love for her friends, her family, her faith, and most of all, herself. Jenna has taken the wisdom gained from her failures and pour it into this honest and moving depth. She shares candid stories about acting, dating, family, friendships, and mental health along short, and you know, I'm not reading all that, but yeah, she talks about everything in here. She talks about, like, how she put her faith into stuff, how, like, she was going through many stuff, how she had to, you know, push some people aside, how she had to not compare herself to other people. Well, yeah, man, well, this book, I don't know, I'm not gonna make it seem like, you know, I'm going crazy and stuff, but I feel like after I read this book, I really saw a different point of view of life and just in general. Like, I really noticed a different way, like, how stuff is really observed in the world. Like, it's hard to explain, but yeah, like, in the book, I don't remember, but it was like one part where she was talking about how, like, when she was an actor, like, in the beginning when she was an actor, she used to compare her acting skills to other people and stuff. And, like, that kind of shows that my point of view, kind of, because I compare my looks. I used to, I don't do it as much, but I used to compare my looks to other people. And that's something she really, like, spoke to me about, and, like, way she stopped it. You know, it just talks about everything. So basically, for my example, I'm just telling you guys to get a book. A book can really help you. And, like, if you like to read, then get a book. Like, get a book that can be helpful for you. Get a book that can cause with growth, you know? Like, just get a book. Read a book. Like, get your mind off of stuff and read a book. You know, read a book. But, yeah. Please read this book. This book was really good. Like, I really like this book. I should get more books, actually. But this was my fave book that really, like, you know, opened my mindset. Like, you know, I think you guys know. Okay, the next thing I'm going to be talking about is meditating. Or just working out in general. I feel like with these big steps, these are the big steps that really, like, shows a difference. Like, it really shows how much you care about yourself and how much you're, like, you're providing to do stuff for yourself, to better yourself. It really shows, like, meditating. I actually tried meditating, I think, a week ago. I'm not saying I do this all the time, but I try to do it as much as I can. And I'm going to put the link in the bio of the video I watched. But I watched this girl. I put it on my TV. I put it loud. I sit down on my bed and I just listen to it. To be honest, the first time, like, I'm a person that gets distracted easily. Like, I hear stuff from a mile away. Like, this video, it actually really helped me. Like, she was telling you the stuff that you should do, like, to focus on, like, and that could really help you, like, just get your mindset into that. Like, meditating really lets your, like, it lets you feel renewed and, like, start over. It's kind of like a workout, you know, but it's not really, like, I feel like with a workout, you're losing weight, but meditating, you're losing the weight off your shoulder. You're losing, like, bad thoughts, bad things off your shoulder. And that's why I really recommend meditating. Like, I'm telling you, it's no joke, for real. Like, the first day I tried it, it really made me so productive that day. That day, I was meditating, I was cleaning, I was journaling, I was doing homework, I fixed my hair. Like, I was really, really on top that day. And I'm just saying, like, working out, meditating can really help with gaining, with distracting yourself, really. Like, it really helps with that. And my friend, too, my friend, Gina, I really mention her a lot, but, yeah, that's my best friend. But, yeah, she was going through something, and she started working out, and she said that working out really helps her with, like, all the stress relieved and stuff. And she says she really sees a difference, you know. And, like, you know, some girls, they really like that. They really like how they're working out and putting that effort, and they're seeing the results, and that's what she's seeing. Like, she's bettering herself. She's not worried about bad stuff like she used to, you know. That's what working out can really help, you know. And I feel like girls should do that. If you really want to get your mind off of somebody or off of anything, try working out or meditating. It can really, like, refresh your mind, for real. But yeah, that is it for this video, you guys. I feel like I talked a lot in this video, but I feel like, I don't know, I feel like my first girl talk video was kind of a little better. This one was just ease, you know. But yeah, I really hope you guys like this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe, and bye. Too cool to be a fool.